The question then becomes, how should I prepare different? How should I prepare different for the 2019 pants? How should we prepare different? And you should ask this to any Board of View course. Anybody who's going to be teaching you this curriculum in 2019, how should you prepare different? Now, I have some strategies. I have some strategies that need to be battle tested, but I'm a gamer. I'm always trying to think, how can I better the system? How can I help people to learn with this new content? Now, here's the first thing that I would say to you. I would say that because the percentages have changed, I'd suggest you study differently. And I'm gonna suggest studying topics on a pyramid. What do you mean by that, John? I mean that the base of the pyramid is the bottom, then you have the middle and the top. So the base are five topics. The five topics I recommend you learn like the back of your hand are cardiac, pulmonary, GI, musculoskeletal, and infectious disease. Now, all of those together are 46%, but quite frankly, I believe it's more than that because infectious disease is way more than 6%. It's more like 10%. How do I know that? Because, you know, if I said pneumonia, you'd say, well, that's infectious disease. No, it's pulmonary. Meningitis. No, that's neurology. So infectious disease is a really big topic, but I'm saying that I don't suggest the students study just infectious disease. You gotta study it my way, the way I've broken down infectious disease into mnemonics so I can memorize all the antibiotics and all the germs, and how there's only really five basic bugs that you gotta know. You have to know your gram-positives, gram-negatives, atypicals, anaerobes, and pseudomonas. So overall, you need about 9 germs to know really well for your boards, okay? So your base topics are the 5. You have to have total mastery of them, but I'm gonna explain what the mastery means. Then you have to have your middle topics. Your middle topics are endo, neurology, and psych, GU, renal, and heme. Those are high yield. Now, when I talk about the first base topics, cardiac, pulmonary, GI, musculoskeletal, and infectious disease, that's 46% of your boards. Now, on the 2019 PANTS, there are 510 disease states, 510. So those base 5 topics are 46% of your boards, and you count out how many disease states are in there, it's 204. So the economics of those 5 are very, very important. Then you have the middle of the base, okay? These middle category topics, endoneurology, psych, GU, renal, and heme. Now, that's 35% of your boards, it's 138 topics. Now, the 3 topics, just based on economics of study, that I de-emphasize, based on content, breadth of content, playing the game, eyes, ears, nose, and throat is 7% of your boards. There's 66 topics there. Reproductive is 7% of your boards, and that is, there's 49 topics there. And dermatology is 5% of your boards, and there's 53 topics. So what I'm gonna suggest to you and de-emphasize to you is, that's only 19% of your boards. It's 19% of your boards, but it's 168 topics, okay? Those 3 topics, eyes, ears, nose, and throat, reproductive, and derm, is 19% of your boards is 168 topics there, as opposed to endo, neurology, psych, GU, renal, and heme, that's 35% of your boards, almost twice as important with less topics. So how am I gonna teach a Board of View course different and stress you learn different? I'm gonna study based on the game and teach you to study based on the game. Like, I'm gonna teach real high yield content. So we have to be stronger in the economics of study. So that's what I recommend. Now I have a study strategy on how to learn them, and I'd suggest watching the next video and looking at the questions of mastery. Okay, this is what I'm telling all the students to do, is to study based on the questions of mastery. So stay tuned for the next video on how to prepare for the 2019 PANTS.